Decor here in the Bump studio. Yes, everybody, welcome back to the Bump. It is, again, our holiday edition, and we all here are hoping you guys have a very safe and happy holiday with your friends and your family. And speaking of friends, I'm joined here with Matt Camp and Ryan Mappola, two of my friends. How are you guys doing?
I'm good. You did not give us the heads up on the gingerbread man outfit? Ginger person outfit? Sure.
Yeah, well, one of us has to be.
Festive Kayla Braxton. That's what I think of in the holiday season.
How you doing over there, Rye? You're festive.
It's not as much as you, but I try. Happy holidays, everybody. Listen, let's keep spreading the holiday cheer all episode long, all week long. Same deal as always. Hashtag WWE The Bump. And we want to hear from you on literally every social platform that exists in this world. So that is Twitter, YouTube chat, Facebook, Instagram, all of them across the board. You got questions for our guests? Ask away. You got comments on the show? Ask away. You bummed that Matt isn't wearing any holiday attire? Hashtag WWE The Bump. Kayla Helmore.
There's a reason for it. They'll understand soon enough.
That's right. Before we discuss who's going to be joining us, we do want to remind you guys that, you know, it is a holiday season, and we really want to extend all the help that we can to those who were affected by the tornadoes a couple of weeks ago in parts of Kentucky, Illinois, Tennessee, Missouri, and Arkansas. WWE is supporting the American Red Cross and their relief effort to help those impacted again by those tornadoes. So let's take a look right now.
Ladies and gentlemen, we invite you to join WWE and support the American Red Cross and their relief efforts for those tragically impacted by tornadoes in the South and Midwest. Text the word tornado to 90999 to donate $10.
As that video just said, text tornado to those numbers you see right there, 90999, again, to help all those who are affected by the tornadoes. It is the holidays. It is Christmas time. And so, again, we just want to do what we can to help those who are in need. So.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, let's talk about who's going to be here on this holiday edition of The Bump. We've got the women's tag team champions, Carmella, and, of course, the Queen's Crown winner, Queen Zelina. Very excited to talk to both of those ladies. And making waves on NXT 2.0, one of the hottest and most decorated factions in the sports entertainment, Diamond Mine will be with us. Malcolm Bivens, you did it. You're going to be here with us on The Bump. It doesn't end there. He's coming on to extend his appearance record here on WWE's The Bump, as long as he doesn't use his sword or put it into any tables. We've got Drew McIntyre joining us here on The Bump.
12 times. 12
times. This will be 12?
12 times.
Oh, it's kind of
12 days of Drew.
The Christmas dozen.
I am festive.
Well, that'll be a calendar maybe we put out, but that means we can't have him again. Anyway.
One of those sites. Go ahead.
It is the end of the year, which is wild to think about, but it's still every single week is always a crazy week in WWE. So let's talk about the brand that I represent, Team SmackDown. You know, the whole night between Paul Heyman, Brock Lesnar, Roman Reigns was extremely eventful. That's a has-been has been watching that over the last several weeks. There's clearly some trust issues between Paul and Roman, possibly rightfully so. But it wasn't until this very line that saw the end of the line for this pairing.
I'm not protecting Brock Lesnar from you. I'm protecting you from Brock Lesnar.
I love you, wise man.
I love you too, my trouble too.
And I thank you for your honesty.
I thank you, my trouble too.
And I thank you for 40 years of service to my family.
I love you, my tribal chief.
And you're fired.
Oh, my God!
Man, you know, I've never said I felt sorry for Paul Heyman once, I think, in our interactions, but this was a moment that I did. We saw that after this attack on Paul, the Beast came down. And overalls, my news you see right here, completely took out the bloodline, shooing away a super kick. Like it was nothing, giving Roman two F5s. Definitely amping, I think, all of us up for the match that's going to be happening. Matt's, you guys can't see, but Matt's mouth is just wide
this
open.
This is the coolest thing I've ever seen.
Do chair shots, Kayla. It's like, I hit me with a chair a couple times, F5.
I've never seen anyone who can just, shoo away super kicks like that. Took out the whole bloodline. Who are we seeing lay out Roman Reigns and the Usos like this?
I love this. I absolutely loved every bit of this because Brock Lesnar rolled into town, as you said, Woo! Took down the Usos. Then we see him get hit with the chair shots.
Then he takes down
Roman Reigns. You said you felt maybe bad for Paul Heyman. You know what Paul Heyman would do, Kayla? If he got two turtle doves, he'd keep them both for himself. Do not feel bad for Paul Heyman, especially with what he put you through.
What was that?
That's a deep cut from home.
Okay, well, anyway, we're all looking forward to what's happening on day one. Can't wait to see how this all transpires. And I'm sure in some way I'll be mixed up in all this, trying to figure out what's going on. And, you know, I'll keep you guys
informed. Kayla.
All right, what's happening over on Raw, Matt?
Come on, get with it. Well, we know we are barreling towards day one, January 1st, WWE Championship. It was a triple threat, and now it's a fatal four-way. And sometimes partnerships can form on the way to a fatal four-way match, and that's exactly what we saw, because the main event of Monday Night Raw was Bobby Lashley and Big E on the same side against Kevin Owens and Seth freaking Rollins. And after Bobby mistakenly hit the spear on the WWE champion, he would hit one on Kevin Owens. But sometimes, and this was a lot of Monday Night Raw, it's not all about wins and losses, because it was very clear that Seth and Kevin wanted to take out two of their opponents. The stomp on Bobby Lashley on the stairs, you got to wonder what kind of condition he will be in heading into day one. These two are hugging, Kevin Owens and Seth freaking Rollins hugging to end Monday Night Raw, but they will be opponents in a few, not even a few weeks, a couple of weeks away now. Fatal four-way WWE Championship, the biggest test to date for our friend Big E. I hate to say it, guys, I think he's in some trouble at day one.
Ooh, we're all looking forward to that. Ryan, what is the WWE Universe saying about all this?
Well, Kayla, a lot. and I also got to tell you, Liv Morgan and Becky Lynch, they don't like each other very much.
No.
And we're going to look at the tweets right now. So, you know, everyone saw the video. Liv Morgan attacked Becky Lynch during a training session. And this resulted in a very tumultuous and personally driven exchange between the two of them this past Monday on Raw, which we have some tweets to support. Liv Morgan really did not hold back on Becky Lynch. As Jerry says here, Liv went full Rebecca, used her full name on Becky Lynch. It's personal now. A lot was said. Ultimately, Liv gains more and more confidence by the week. That is exhibited in this tweet here from Liv herself. Who said, point blank, we can flip to the next one here, that, you know, one, two, Liv, he's coming for you, and by you, I mean you, Becky. This is a collision course for day one. Liv Morgan, despite the tough loss a couple weeks ago, again, she's gaining confidence by the week. I think Becky, Matt, you said Big E has something to worry about. I think Becky might have something to worry about as well.
Maybe. I don't know. Liv's got to get that big momentum next week on Raw. I think she needs it more than anybody heading into day one.
She's proven why she's where she is, though, right now.
100%. Someone else who always proves why they deserve to be where they are is AJ Styles. However, it's been a tough week for AJ Styles. It started on Monday. AJ and Omos, no more. As the WWE account said, end of an era, to which AJ replied again. And now these two are going to, you know, go at it next week. AJ said, end of an era and of a bright future. No one should ever forget who I am. That was in direction, we think, to Omos. And then Kona says here, I haven't cried like this since Titanic.
I'm with you, Kona.
AJ and Omos were a great tag team. But the reason I said what I said about AJ's tweet is because, in terms of who it was in reference to, is because he also had a tumultuous yesterday with Grayson Waller. And, you know, Grayson Waller called out AJ on social. AJ responded. He showed up at NXT 2.0 last night. This is just one of the many tweets we could say from this exchange last night. Grayson said, you're here because your meal ticket left you last night. That's Omos. Ultimately, AJ wanted to throw down with Grayson last night. Grayson, you know, he said all the right things, but then he bounced. So we got somebody here saying Grayson Waller fears AJ Styles. And then that's Trix put. Now, this is, I mean, Grayson is the biggest, make of that what you will, in the world. I wish AJ whooped his, I'm going to say butt, because it's the holiday season. more to come there. Who knows? But AJ has a lot going on. However, if there's one person who can juggle multiple conflicts like this, it is a surefire first ballot Hall of Famer in AJ Styles. A first ballot Hall of Fame move happened on Monday, though, and it overtook Twitter, and we need to talk about it. Bianca Belair with, I'm just going to call it, the greatest KOD in the history of KODs. Let's look at the reaction from it, because Bianca herself weighed in, do drop it like it's hot.
Ooh, I like that.
Which is a very clever play on words. Well done, Bianca. But the reaction to this was all over the place. Bianca, again, stop playing with me with many E's, and ultimately E-S-T. Bianca, you continue to amaze us. Happy holidays to you and to the greatest KOD of all time.
It was amazing.
She's just incredible. Yes. I feel like I could just tweet that every single day, and it's just always going to be true that Bianca Belair is going to go down as one of the best of all time.
That is going to be in every highlight package for the rest of her career. It should be in anything ever in WWE history. It was that awesome, and you saw the crowd just come to their feet as
all
it went down.
Time.
It was awesome.
Yep. Jeez.
She's good.
All right, well, before we bring on our first guest, we want to remind everyone, especially because it is the holiday season, that you shouldn't let the supply chain get you down. WrestleMania tickets make a great holiday gift. Be part of the most stupendous two-night WrestleMania in history. Let's take a look.
Empty boxes?
Sorry, kids. It's not Santa's fault. It was the supply chain. But there is one box you didn't open. That small one right there.
If you are not a part of this live, you are missing the most stupendous event of your lifetime.
The only gift that guarantees a Merry Christmas. WrestleMania 38, the most stupendous two-night WrestleMania in history.
That's right, everyone. WrestleMania 38 in Dallas at the AT&T Stadium. Tickets are available now and available at SeatGeek for the two-night event on Saturday, April the 7th, and Sunday.
You can be there by yourself on the 7th, but it will be there the 2nd and 3rd.
But anyway, yes, get your tickets. We are all super excited for WrestleMania. All right, guys, it is now time to bring on two women that have had a very big last few months. One is a queen, and the other is the most beautiful woman in all of WWE, but they are both champions. They're the Women's Tag Team Champions. They're taking the division by storm. We're excited to bring them on to the bump right now. Carmella and Queen Zelina. Hello.
Yeah. Hello.
Hello, peasant.
Yes, queen.
how are you ladies feeling today? Zelina, I'll start with you. Great bucket hat there.
Queen Zelina.
Queen Zelina. I'm working on it. Queen Zelina.
All right, I was going to correct you because I'm not sure what kind of swamp you crawled out of, but, you know, it's raining here, so I had to make sure I look good still as queen, you know, walking around and still stunting like I do.
Okay. Carmella, the most beautiful woman in all of WWE, how are you feeling?
Well, you know, I'm in Pittsburgh and it's pretty cold here, so I have a different hat on. So, but I still look beautiful.
We all talk in accents.
Nope.
Of course okay. You do. Look at you.
All right. Well, let's get right into things, ladies, and starting with what happened on Monday. The previous week, we saw you, Queen Zelina, defeat former Raw Women's Champion. But on Monday, she kind of evened the score with a very decisive victory. We're watching this back right now. What are you taking away from this last match here between you two?
First of all, those dairy-loving farm peasants distracted me. Okay, so I just have to restart my undefeated streak, that's all. I mean, look what I did right there. No one else can do that. No one else in the company can do what I do. So right there, I should have won right there, but there was a spider, so I think it kind of spooked Rhea a little bit to jump up the way she did. So I look at it as a fluke. It's a fluke, period. So I just have to restart my undefeated streak. That's all.
Okay, I mean, I appreciate the optimism there.
Can I just say, I'm going to interrupt here. It is so disrespectful to bring us onto the bump and then show that clip. Like, why did you guys need to do that? You couldn't have a better clip to show? That is so disrespectful to the queen.
Hello.
That is rude.
Matt, did you put that in there?
No, Kayla, you asked the question. Why are you passing the buck? What kind of team
are we? I know. Look at you.
Sorry.
We can play Lord Farquaad and Little Gingerbread Person. If you want to go that way, Kayla, if you want to start there. Get you on the slab, you know, start picking at your little buttons.
Oh, boy. Let's talk about happier times. Carmella, you two, obviously, you hold the WWE Women's Tag Team Championships. Congratulations on that. Why are you and Queen Zelina better representatives than Rhea Ripley and Nikki A.S.H. as the Women's Tag Team Champions?
Is that a serious question? I mean, the shorter list is how are we not? I mean, Nikki A.S.H., she's almost a superhero. She doesn't even know who she is, what she is. Rhea Ripley just comes around, like, putting her little signs up with her hand. She wears black lipstick. Like, I don't even know what she's doing. Like, look how cute we are. Look at us. No one's doing it better than us. We have the queen, and you have the most beautiful woman in all of WWE. Also, I'm the princess of Staten Island. You have the queen, you have the princess. We're a way better pair. Come on.
There. Very royal.
Ladies, to that point, as we see her on social media, there are many people saying that Rhea and Nikki may be having some dissension. Maybe it's time for them to go their separate ways. I'm curious what your two thoughts on that. Queen, we'll start with you.
I mean, not saying that it was easy, but I mean, come on, look at them. It was super easy. All you really had to do is just show them a mirror and you'd see right away they're not meant for each other. They're not meant for these titles like me and Carmella. I mean, she's the most beautiful woman in WWE. Look at her. Like, that's the real question. I listened to this stuff for just a second, and you're talking about how great Bianca Belair is and what she can do and how she's so strong and blah, 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 blah. But then how about how amazing the queen is and how I had an undefeated streak for months and months and how beautiful. And mind you, she's the first Money in the Bank winner. She's the princess of Staten Island. Like, what about us? What about our accolades? Like, hello?
Yeah, you guys have.
That's why you're on the show.
Exactly.
We're talking about all that stuff now.
And Carmella, you know, you've had some partners in the past, and you have a lot of achievements that you have racked up in your time here in WWE. But
Let's name the achievements. If we're going to talk about Bianca, let's talk about my achievements.
Well, obviously, yeah. First ever Miss Money in the Bank.
Money in the Bank. And the second.
You've done it again.
Cashing on Charlotte Flair.
Two times. SmackDown Women's Champion.
Yeah. SmackDown was champion. I won the WrestleMania Women's Battle Royal. I won the Mixed Match Challenge with R-Truth. Now I'm the Tag Team Champion.
24/7 champion twice.
Talk about Hall of Fame. Are you kidding? Right here, sitting right here in front of you.
So we just listed all your achievements, but this is your first time with gold as a tag team. So how do you rank this achievement to these other ones that you just listed?
You can't put one over the other. I mean, this is just as important. This is the first time I've held a tag team championship, and it's with Queen Zelina. And I think it's only fitting that it's with Queen Zelina. We have history together, and there's no one else I'd rather have won the championships with.
Well, I was going to ask you, with the fact that you have been teamed up with other people, how do you compare Queen Zelina to other
partners, like an R-Truth?
Well, Queen Zelina knows what it takes to get things done. She'll do whatever it takes. And that's something that I am no stranger to. And I recognize that in her. And I think she recognizes that in me. We both do whatever it takes to win. And if sometimes we have to, you know, use the other person to get ahead, that's what we'll do. And we're not ashamed to admit that. That's what we do. We're both in this to get ahead and to be champion. And that's what we're doing.
Queen Zelina, obviously you win the Queen's Crown Tournament, historic in itself. You become the first queen, but you're in now your first championship reign in WWE. I know it's something you've thought about for a long time. Has it lived up to everything you hoped it would be?
Well, that and more. I mean, I just feel like there needs to be more, too. Like, yes, Carmella and I have a red carpet, but where's our roses? Where's people lifting us up and walking us down to the ring? I mean, we're royalty. So where's all these things? I'm looking at this like, yes, I'm the queen and I'm the champion. So why is it that, you know, I look around and I see highlight reels and other people? Why is it that other people, Bianca's not even a champion. Liv's not even a champion. And you're talking about them as if they matter like we do. Listen, I'm even a new crown might be on the way. Let's just say that there's many things in store for the queen. And I mean, I think Carmella's missing a little bit of shine too.
Okay.
Well,
I agree. I think maybe a little tiara can be the princess, the queen. We need to have like a big celebration. We need to celebrate how incredible we are and how amazing we are. We need to talk about it a little bit more. Coming out and being in the same ring as Rhea Ripley and Nikki ASH is doing nothing for us. It's embarrassing to even be associated with them. They're so below us. It's disgusting.
And beating them.
Yes.
Queen Zelina, in terms of more gold, you're talking about crowns, but you had this tweet from a few days ago where you had some bold proclamations. Mark my words, I'll be queen, women's tag team champion, and Raw women's champion all at the same time. You'd be the first person to ever do that. Literally be making history. Would you say that's your top goal heading into 2022?
That is absolutely my top goal. Listen, like, you have to be a history maker, you have to be willing to go the extra mile. And like I said, Carmella and I know business is first. You know, our friendship, we're amazing together. But ultimately, we see the future in how we deserve to be represented. I feel that I deserve to be represented as the queen, the tag team champion, and the Raw women's champion. I mean, really, I made history as queen. I made history as being queen that's a tag team champion. And now I want to be a queen that's a tag team champion and a Raw women's champion.
And-
Period.
Absolutely. And Carmella, speaking of goals, you also had a tweet of a different variety, though. Putting my name in to fill in for Wendy Williams for the rest of this season. My resume includes spilling the tea, staying up to date with all the celebrity gossip, and loving all things Real Housewives. I want to spin this a little bit. Would you two ever consider hosting a talk show together?
Ooh. Me as first guest. Ooh.
I would love that. Oh, my gosh. I am so obsessed with spilling the tea, and I love all these trashy reality shows. I would just love to talk about it all day long and have the queen there with me, and we can just chat and drink champagne and be royal and beautiful and pretty. Come on.
I love that. I've already accepted the guest position whenever you guys would want me to be on there. So.
Might have to wait a while.
No one invited you, Kayla. No one will. Get over yourself and your little things, whatever they are.
These little buns. They're very cute and very fashionable.
Yeah.
You did mention, you know, that you guys think you need, you know, a little more shine, a little more of a celebration. Queen Zelina, would you know that Carmella is, or, you know, is self-proclaimed as the most beautiful woman in all of WWE? And you are.
Self-proclaimed. You said it, Kayla.
You are the most beautiful woman in all of WWE. I think in the world, to be honest. But have you given Carmella an official royal title, kind of like King Woods did for the hand of the king, Sir Kofi Kingston? Have you thought about a title for Carmella?
I mean, I think we're still working it out. It needs to fit her. It needs to be perfect because she has such a perfect face. It needs to fit her. So her and I are still in talks, as it were, and just coming up with something that's fitting of the princess. I just feel like it needs to be perfect. Everything we do is perfect. And, you know, really, Kayla, for you to be asking that kind of a question is kind of funny, but, you know, because you'll never be in that position. So I get you wanting to know all that stuff. But really, when it comes down to it, it needs to be perfect. We never do anything, you know, like, can I say half-butted or
perfection.
Ask her another?
Yeah, you can say whatever you want.
Exactly, can't do that. No,
no, she can't. Do not say that.
She's the queen. Yeah, she can say whatever she wants. You're the
town
gossip.
You can't do anything with half your butt, okay?
Carmella, is your wine the official royal beverage of the queen's reign?
Oh, yes, honey. Cup of Kanye means boss babe, and that's what we both are. We're both boss babes. I love that for us. Nothing but the best for Queen Zelina.
Aw. Oh, listen, Queen Zelina, you and King Wood seem to be very supportive and happy for each other when you guys won your respective tournaments. How would you compare your royal reign so far? Have you guys been giving each other some tricks on the royal way of life? Some tricks and tips?
Some tricks, some tips. And I just feel like with King Woods, he's wanted this for so long that he just has, you know, an extra leg up on the game. And he's just really helped me come out of my royal shell, because I wanted to be queen, but now I want to take everything to the next level. And he just helps me kind of dig deep and see what's going to be fitting of me. And I feel like also, really, you kind of made the game a king and queen of the world. It's not even just WWE, but the world. And now it's just like, we want to take over even more. I mean, look at this. When in history have you ever seen it where you get two people like King Woods and I to rule the kingdom of WWE? When has that ever happened? I'll answer for you, never.
Never.
So it's important.
Answers never. And Queen Zelina, people have taken notice so much that we pulled the WWE Universe for questions for both of you. We got a ton of responses. We're going to dive into some of them now. This first one's from Joe Burns, who's asking, Zelina, this is for you. Who's been your favorite opponent to hit the code right on? And do you two plan on having matching gear at any point soon in the future?
I have to say, probably Liv, because I think she's really delusional and thinking that she's going to become the champion. So probably Liv, and I would just probably do it over and over and over again. We had a little tip with her once before. So, Liv.
Fair. Right on. Carmella, we're going to throw this next one to you. This is for Gareth. This is from Gareth, excuse me. We can throw it to both of you, though. What's the one Christmas gift you asked for as a child but never got? Gareth wants to know.
Oh, honey, I always get what I want.
That's what I figured.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Yeah.
Zelina,
yeah,
Queen,
that's
really for you.
I don't know if there's anything. Yeah, I don't really think there's anything. I mean, I wanted a PlayStation. I got a PlayStation. I wanted an Xbox. I got that too. So, I mean, really, there's nothing. And now, as a Christmas gift, not only am I Queen, but we're also the champions. So, nice Christmas present for us too. And birthday present. By the way, Monday, the 27th, is my birthday. So, I want gifts from all of you. All of you.
Makes sense.
I got you.
Right on that.
Makes sense. Queen, perfect segue. You're good at everything you do, because the next question here is from Chris asking, what is your favorite video game at the moment? Possibly a PlayStation title.
Ooh, Ooh, that's hard. But I have to say, probably either Mortal Kombat, but right now I'm playing Pokemon Pearl. So, yeah, I'd say Pokemon Pearl right now.
Right on. And then one more. This is from Raj. I feel like it's within Kayla and mine, though. Raj wants you to rate the bump members from 0 to 10. This is
Whoa.
For both of you. I mean, it includes all three of us, but I feel like Kayla may have been in mind when Raj asked.
Princess, please go first.
Okay, well, I'm just going to say, there's only... I don't know how you rate them here. There's really no one that's better than the other, you know?
Okay, I can disagree with that one.
I do like Kayla. Kayla's
I
cute.
Can say, thank
so
you.
Kayla's number one for me.
Who's
Hunky Dory?
Darling, no. She's a -5.
Yes.
Oh. I'm going to go there. Go to -5.
Oh.
The other two, I mean, Matt, after that tweet, I mean, you're kind of in, like, the one range right now with me, so we'll stay there. And then the other one, we'll give you 5.
Yeah, he's the worst. The other one's the worst. We can't stand him. The other one, ew.
We just have different
I thought
lives.
We were on the men.
He's a big live fan.
I thought we were on the
oh,
men.
Oh, that's true.
Okay, we can move on to the next question. Maybe.
All right, we'll move on. Thank you. Carmella, considering you've only been on the red brand for a couple of months and for the first time in your career, has it lived up to your expectations so far?
I mean, so far, so good. I'm out there looking cute. It's Melanite Raw. I mean, I get to be with my fiance. I think it's going very well, you know? Tag team champion, beat Liv a million times. And yeah, I mean, look at this. Look how good we are.
And Queen Zelina, you
oh,
know.
Look at my handsome fiance in the background.
Queen Zelina, you know, it is the holiday season. So with that, are you granting any royal wishes or either of you bestowing any gifts upon common folk, like, I guess, us here in the Bump studio?
Oh, you weren't joking. Okay. Sorry. No.
Okay.
Not at all. Not even a little bit. No. However, my birthday. Remember my birthday, you know, so you might want to bring all
you
that
said
this
your birthday's
way.
Next
Kayla,
year.
Kayla, if you send... Yeah, no. If you send roses with, like, little maggots and stuff, I will come for you. Just know that.
Okay.
No
well,
roses.
Do that, you know what? We are so grateful that you guys took the time to be on the Bump today, and, you know, we wish you guys all the best, and happy holidays.
Happy early birthday, Queen.
Yeah.
Thank you, Bob.
Yes,
oh, thank
queen.
You.
Happy birthday.
You.
I did have this bow
thank
to put
you.
On,
acknowledge
but
the princess.
Oh, there
oh, nice. Look at
there
you.
Go.
Right there.
I'm the gift.
She's the gift.
You're welcome. Here's your gift.
Thank you. Wow.
Perfect.
Thank you, guys.
Most second accessible.
Bye.
They're wonderful.
Oh, they are just, I love Carmella so much.
And Queen Zelina.
Anyway, so before we do bring on our next guest, Diamond Mine, we do want to go ahead and let you guys know who's going to be on next week's show.
Oh, the countdown.
It is back.
And a two.
One. Woo! Legendary X-Punk joining us here on the Bump, and of course the almighty Bobby Lash. It's going to be a good one. It's going to be our very last episode of 2021 ahead of our special episode of day one to start off the new year 2022. So make sure you guys come back next week. It's going to be a fun show.
By the way, when Bobby comes on the show, usually good things happen after. The last time when he was on last year, he was WWE champion 8 days later. Maybe it'll happen again.
Oh, okay. Well, I guess we'll have to wait and see. All right, let's go ahead and bring on our next guests. It's a very plural word because we've got a lot of them here. It was announced last night that the current Cruiserweight champion Roderick Strong will be facing off against North American champion Carmelo Hayes at New Year's Evil. So without further ado, we're bringing all of these guys on now. Roderick Strong, the Creed brothers, Julius and Brutus, Ivy Nile, and accompanied by the voice of this table for the first time finally here on the
Bump
after 3 years, Malcolm Bivens.
Diamond Mine here.
Welcome.
Oh. It only took 3 years.
Congratulations.
Thank you. I appreciate it. How's it going, Kayla?
Hi, Malcolm. I don't really know
what
Matt Camp how this all. This wasn't my choice that you were on today, but you know we're still. It is the holiday season, so I'm glad I could give you this gift. So thank you.
Thank you.
Oh wow.
All right. Well.
Why are you so mean, Kayla? You bumped them off the.
I also appreciate the fact that, listen, you have two heavyweights back to back. right? You have me, and then you have Bobby Lashley next week.
Oh,
I appreciate it.
Okay. Well, anyway, welcome, guys, to the show. You guys, big money matches keep piling up for Diamond Mine. Last week, it was Bron Breakker, and after multiple run-ins with Trick Williams and North American champion Carmelo Hayes, Roderick and Malcolm, you guys laid down the challenge for champion versus champion, title versus title match at New Year's Evil. Malcolm, let's take a look back at what you had to say.
Carmelo and Trick, you didn't like the gift we gave you? See, that is what happens when you disrespect us. Because Diamond Mine is about two things, right? Respect and money.
Tell him, Malcolm.
Hell yeah.
And we all want the big paydays that go along with the big money matches. So how about this? At New Year's Evil, Mr. North American Champion, who's been talking all that trash, the self-proclaimed A-Champion versus the champion of NXT, Roderick Strong, champion versus champion, title versus title. What do you say, Carmelo?
Melo, you have 2 weeks to find those balls.
Oh, yeah. Merry Christmas, ho. Ho. Ho.
All right. Well, listen, Malcolm, you know, the money is always good, but is this also kind of about knocking Melo down a few notches?
Of course, of course. Him, Trick Williams, I mean, they've been talking trash for weeks upon weeks upon weeks. So, like we've said, it's all about the big money matches, right? He calls himself the A-champion. He's right. He is a champion, but he is not the champion like Roderick Strong. Tell him.
Exactly.
And Roddy,
Carmelo needs to be humbled.
Go ahead, Roddy. I mean, that's this is what I want to tell you, because
Malcolm
said this. Right. Malcolm said, you're the champion. And I think that's very important, because you've established yourself. You're kind of, you know, the link between what NXT was, what it is now. But where do you see yourself in the grand scheme of NXT 2.0?
I see myself holding every title. I mean, I obviously only need one more title to be the first person to hold every single title in NXT. Wow, so yes. After I beat Carmelo, I'll be on to either Bron Breakker or Tommaso Ciampa.
Oh,
I like
it. Also
that.
A massive match coming up at New Year's Evil. Last week, everyone, we asked Melo and Trick about dealing with Diamond Mind, and this is what they had to say. Let's take a look.
Yeah, we're getting real sick of Dexter Lumis and Malcolm Bivens, too. Like, we just started working with Malcolm Bivens, and he's already getting on our nerves.
He's a nice guy. He's all right. Hey, listen.
Matt Cam is a big Malcolm.
Well, we're buddies. Everybody knows that. Trick, I got to ask you, though, as you do a lot of the talking, Bivens does a lot of the talk for Diamond Mine. He's in his element on Twitter. Can you handle that? Can you go back at him? Can you match him?
My debut, what I said is what I said. I was born with the gift of the gab and the gift of the jab. And there's no one who can match me on the mic in this business. And I mean that.
All right, Malcolm, you're with us a week later. You've heard the comments. What do you have to say to those two gentlemen?
I have two things. First of all, I'll slap the hot sauce out of Trick Williams' mouth. The second thing is, what was that background? Were they at the dentist? What was it?
We think it was a yoga studio.
Yeah, we weren't really sure either.
Yeah,
he could talk, but he sure can't move.
Exactly. So that's what I have to say about them. That's all they do. That's all they do. So New Year's Evil, we're going to put a stop to that.
Right on. Let's switch gears a little bit here, all, because last week the Creed brothers introduced the world to one of the most unique training regimens, quite frankly, we've ever seen. We're going to take a look at it here. Now, I'm told this particular workout is called the Stroke.
The Stoke.
Is this just another example of Diamond Mine being at the forefront of cutting-edge training techniques?
Julius Brutus, tell him.
No, it's just the cool down. This isn't even the warm up. This is just the cool down after the workout.
Right. People think that's fake weights. That's real stuff. They just don't know what it's like because they've never done it.
And listen, I tried it myself. I just got discharged from the hospital this morning. That's how incredible that workout is.
He didn't even make the backflip, though.
Nope.
Crushed his whole face.
Well, Julius and Zach Gibson went back and forth on Twitter about this innovative workout, which led to the match that happened last night. How do you respond to him being so dismissive, especially after the two teams met with no definitive conclusion?
Boys?
If people haven't seen something before, they're not sure what to say about it. He's never seen anybody like us. He's never been in the ring with people like us, so he wasn't sure what to make of it. He found out quickly, though. Look at him. They're staying down on the knee while we're finishing the match.
Guys, look.
Sound a tad jealous to me.
I think jealous. The correct word, the proper word, is shook if.
Shook if.
Right? That's Grizzly Young Veterans. Shook if.
And let's talk about Ivy. We know Ivy was a part of The Rock show, Titan Games, on NBC. So, Malcolm, yes. Did you exchange any texts with him before you brought her on board to Diamond Mine?
I did. It was about getting Ivy the best deal with us, and it was also about me being in the next Fast and Furious franchise. He left me on red about that, but with Ivy, he said she was incredible. Ivy, how was that experience?
Oh gosh, it was very surreal. It was everything I've trained for, you know, doing something like that and having him be there. And literally, I was about to compete, and he was standing right there. And I mean, it was just the most insane experience.
Right?
And of course, for me, it was like a dream come true competing and under the lights. And yeah, it was.
That's awesome.
Everything I've trained for.
I think we need our own show.
Yeah.
Everyone just training and doing different things.
I think so, yeah.
Because we have some beasts back here.
Yep, yep,
it's unfreaking
believable.
Yep.
And me watching you guys train, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. I like that. I like that. Smart man. Yeah. Smart man.
From one great to another, from The Rock to Malcolm Bivens, we talk about definitive, right? And we have seen Ivy in the ring absolutely dominate. Ivy, you are undefeated as a member of Diamond Mine with your latest, most impressive victory coming last week against the Mari Miller. How would you describe your in-ring style?
I'm relentless. You know, everything from my Brazilian jiu-jitsu training to working with these guys. I mean, I have the best resources with me right now. I'm adaptable. I can adapt with any girl that I face. I mean, I can square up and I can get my finish in. And I mean,
it's all about the squeeze.
Yeah, I think more adaptable. I think I can adapt and I can be relentless. And I mean,
I gotta ask though, is the showboating the Malcolm influence on this whole thing? Because you certainly like to show off in the ring.
Showboating. I mean, I don't really know if that means like the push-ups and stuff. I mean, that's just like a.
That's her.
It's just a normal day.
That's her, man.
Muscle memory.
Yeah, she is the pit bull of NXT. Pit bull got his name from her. Give me the green light. That was about her, man.
Yeah.
That was about her.
Yeah.
Wow. Well, that's awesome. Recognize. Wow, another piece of great trivia there about Diamond Mine. So, Malcolm, we have a great research team here at WWE's The Bump. July 1st, 2004. JBL making his first WWE. Wait, who is that right there? Who's taking pictures? Let's take another look at this. Maybe the most important handshake in the history of WWE. JBL making his first WWE Championship intro, entrance. He's about big money matches. Did this really set you on your course, Malcolm?
It did. It did. Also, that was a big-ass camera that I had. I think that was a Panasonic. But yes, at that time, I was a big fan of JBL, still am. The Cabinet, that was my jam. That was my jam. Orlando Jordan, the Basham Brothers. Oh, man, I remember that show vividly. And yeah, I had the time of my life. I think I was, I don't want to date myself. I think I was 16, 17 years old.
Right, sure.
At that time.
Oh, wow.
He slipped you a 10 there, too.
Yeah.
That was nice. He was that rich.
Yep. And I slipped him a business card on the low. Y'all didn't see it. You know, I was broke back then, so I just wrote it on a piece of paper. But, I gave him my business card.
A business card paper.
Yep. Thank
you. Roddy, as you see that, are you realizing you're working with the right man now?
Oh, 100%. That sealed it for me.
Birdman hand rub.
Oh, you guys are great. Well, listen,
good stuff. Thank
we
you.
Know what time is money, and money
He's
is power. But do you guys have any special holiday greetings for everyone watching right now before we say goodbye?
Special holiday greetings.
Yeah, I would just say Diamond Mine is the best. Diamond Mine forever, ever, 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 ever.
Buy our merchandise.
Yes. Yeah,
that's I want to say.
We got these on sale now. You know, we got the Diamond Mine T-shirts.
On sale.
You know, we got the towels. We got some. Yep. We got some Diamond Mine grills coming.
Got the NFTs.
We got some Diamond Mine kits coming.
Tattoos.
Yep. There you go. Go to my Twitter. I got some NFTs for sale.
Oh,
holler at me.
Keep an eye out.
Invisible minted on invisible ink, right? We thinking ahead, right? Everybody else in what, 2021? We in 2035.
Wow, all right.
By the way, thank you for sending me the jacket. I really appreciate it. I don't know if I deserve this, but I got one too.
I didn't send you that.
Nope. Well, where? Never mind. Came off a truck. But the hoodies are on shop right now.
No, that ain't what? Even real.
Hey, can we connect to HR real quick?
Let's go. Hey, that was good. They had a good time, right? It was great having them on.
Thank you guys for coming on. And Malcolm, I've been instructed to tell you that you're welcome back anytime, but I'm going to make sure that that's
they all are. Well, we like all of them.
Diamond Mine is 100% welcome back anytime, but we'll talk more about
next time we're going to come in studio.
One last question, Kayla, for you.
Yes.
What's your favorite Boyz II Men song?
Well, that would have been mine.
Say that.
Oh, well, I'm not saying that because I thought I'm walking into a trap.
Did you whisper in her ear?
No.
Well, I'm not walking into a trap. I mean, I'll make.
Say it.
I'm not going to say it, but you know what I'm saying. Love, I'll make love to you.
There it is.
Yeah,
good choice. Yeah, okay.
That was a little aggressive.
Get out of here.
I'll see y'all later.
To you?
Yeah. That was a little aggressive.
Goodbye.
I wasn't ready for that one, bro. Okay. Bye.
Goodbye.
Thanks, everybody. Pleasure.
Goodbye. Yeah. Adios.
Good luck. Diamond forever.
Oh, Lord.
You need a suit over that. Watch Woo. Out.
Shout out to Boyz II Men.
Yeah, I know.
Well, sorry, Ryan. I'm surprised they didn't direct that to you.
What a show so far. We've been having a good time. But before we do bring on our next guests, we want to remind everyone to go out and download the Season 8 of WWE Supercard, which, by the way, has gone on more than 25 million downloads since it debuted back in August of 2014.
And by the way, if that wasn't incentive enough, ring in the holidays with WWE Supercard Arctic Expedition Questline. Enter the Arctic Expedition Quest until January 1st and go on the trail of the abominable snowman. That's right, the Yeti roaming around. There is one roaming around. Battle on the mat with your latest Valhalla cards and collect Yeti teeth. Very nice. That can be exchanged for Yeti-themed cards and more.
And to talk about some of these new cards and with what's going on as we lead up to day one, he's back here on the bump for the 12th time, Drew McIntyre.
Yeah.
Drew.
Hello.
How are we?
Good, sir. 12 times. Before you came on, Matt proposed we do something called 12 Days of Drew.
Just every appearance.
Every appearance.
Oh, yeah? Have you got a video for me or a song, perhaps? 12 Days of Drew?
I figured you'd want to sing when you came on right now, right? It's early morning. You're good.
I had a song in mind, but, I saw that last segment. I don't have the Diamond Mind audio, just y'all's audio. So Kayla's last words kind of distracted me for a second. I don't know what y'all were talking about, but things have got interesting on the bump since my last appearance, I see.
There's been a lot going on. So, listen, Kayla
I think it was a song, perhaps. I don't know for sure. But
it might have been a song. It might have been. We're talking about Supercard here with you. Let's get to those cards that we just mentioned because there's a lot to talk about with these cards. You can play WWE Supercard and unwrap free gifts during the holiday. As you mentioned on the last show, there are three card tiers, Meyer, Maelstrom, and Valhalla, with the strongest talent legends in the game. Let's check them out there. We'll start off with Holiday Maelstrom, Nikki A.S.H., and then we'll move on. We were just talking NXT with Diamond Mind. There is Holiday Maelstrom, Kushida. Over to SmackDown, we have Holiday Meyer, Happy Corbin. Couldn't be happier. We'll talk with Drew about that in a little bit. And he just came back to Monday Night Raw, Holiday Valhalla, The Miz. Someone who joined us right here in the studio last week, Holiday Maelstrom, Sami Zayn. And his friend or enemy or whatever, someone who will challenge for the WWE Championship at day one, Holiday Maelstrom, Kevin Owens. Going back over to the NXT side, a little banged up right now. Holiday Valhalla, LA Knight. Drew, I promise we're getting there. There's a big one coming. But back over to Raw, Holiday Meyer, Randy Orton. Someone we haven't seen in a little while. Holiday Valhalla, Alexa Bliss. And victorious last night over Dakota Kai in a street fight, Holiday Meyer, Raquel Gonzalez. And drum roll, the one we've all been waiting for. Kayla mentioned it before. The Yeti-themed cards. Here is none other than Yeti Valhalla, Drew McIntyre.
With your sword.
Drew, what do you think of that?
Awesome looking card.
Yeah.
That's pretty, pretty cool. And I love that you pronounce Yeti, Yeti, the way it's supposed to be pronounced.
That's correct. You understood that. The 18 new holiday cards include superstars like Alexa Bliss, Kevin Owens, Nikki A.S.H., Raquel Gonzalez, Randy Orton, Happy Corbin, and The Miz. So if you want to get your hands on those cards, play now.
Woo! All right. Well, Drew, let's switch gears here and get back into what's happening in the ring. This battle with Madcap Moss will be your first pay-per-view singles match as a member of the Blue Brand. Obviously, you know, we know you want to win, but is your performance also about sending a strong message to the locker room and WWE officials as we begin the new year?
Yeah, 100%. Well, since I moved to SmackDown, I said from day one, I'm willing to go through absolutely everybody, prove myself all over again till I inevitably get my shot at the Universal Championship. I'm excited for this match in particular. I'm not overlooking Madcap. You know, his jokes are terrible. So terrible. He's aligned with Corbin. He's such a horrible human being. But this is a guy who's a legitimate high-level athlete. If you followed him in NXT at all, when they had the combine competitions, he crushed absolutely everybody. I mean, I could have been part of them. I remember them asking me one time when I was in NXT, Drew, do you want me in the combine? I said, absolutely not. I'm not going to injure myself. But the guy was an absolute machine. He did suffer a couple of injuries, an ACL injury, a knee injury. He battled back stronger every time. So I'm not looking past Madcap. I'm looking forward to this match, see what he's got. Until you're in the ring with somebody, you don't know how truly good they actually are. I know he's going to bring his absolute best, and I think people are going to be surprised by how good this match actually is.
Well, with you giving us the background there of Madcap Moss, the part of that is this will be his pay-per-view debut in WWE. Does it add any extra motivation to spoil the biggest match of his career?
Oh, yeah, I'm going to destroy him and beat him. I just seen a lot of the chatter that people are unsure about Madcap in the ring, and I just want to let them know, don't get too ahead of ourselves yet. That's the way I'm always thinking now, is just don't look past the next obstacle. And the next obstacle is Madcap. He's an incredible athlete. I really do think people are going to be looking at him differently after this match, but at the same time, I'm still going to beat his arse and win.
Oh, all right. Drew, you mentioned Twitter. As we're going to see here in a second, there's been a lot of talk on Twitter about, and you addressed it, Madcap's comedy. We're going to see a tweet here from Chino, who just is not a fan, and I could have found literally hundreds, thousands of these. Hard-hitting journalism, Drew. How would you improve Madcap's comedy, if at all? How would you help with his jokes?
Just have them stop telling them. They're just terrific. Like, I do genuinely laugh at their reaction to their own jokes. That's the only time it's actually funny, is they tell the terrible jokes, and then their response, they both laugh so ridiculously. I do genuinely laugh at that. Even at SmackDown last week, once they stole the sword, and I was watching a couple of the jokes before I picked my moment to hit the ring and get the sword back, and the jokes were awful, but they're reactions, their laughter genuinely had me laughing. You saw when I walked out, I wasn't like, oh, I'm so angry, I'm going to get my sword back. I was like, all right, you guys are, you know, pretty funny. Not the jokes, but your reactions to everything. But I'm going to get the sword back and probably try and maim you. So it's lucky Corbin get out of the way, because I don't know what would have happened if he didn't. But nonetheless, I'm looking forward to this match.
Why do you think so many of your opponents try to mess with Angela? What's...
I don't know. They're just insane. I mean, I used to be called the Scottish psychopath. That wasn't just like a nickname just given to me for the heck of it. I do have this other side that's a little bit wild, and they gave me a sword. So I don't know what's wrong with people. Like, maybe they want to get hurt. I hope they're very fast. Corbin luckily got out of the way when I was swinging that sword, because inevitably, you know, Angela's going to connect with somebody. Are we still PG?
Well, it won't be after that. Listen, Drew, there's still an unsolved mystery out there. Yourself, King Woods, the Intercontinental Champion Shinsuke Nakamura, were all left out of the Black Friday Invitational Battle Royal. It seems like Adam Pearce and Sony Deville have passed the buck on to a higher authority. Are you any closer to an answer as to why you or all three of you were left out of such a prestigious match?
No, I'm still searching for the answers myself. You know, Pierce tried to blame Sheamus off camera, which made sense, I guess, considering the history with myself and Sheamus over this past year. But when he says about the higher power, I don't know. I kind of have a feeling who's pulling the strings on SmackDown in particular. My first thought when I heard higher power
was, it was me, Drew, it was me all along. I assume it's probably not that. So I'm thinking it's probably somebody on the show who's a little worried about Drew McIntyre and getting in the ring with him.
Oh, okay. I will just let that sit there. But Drew, on the topic, like this tweet from Kyle Lewis demonstrates, Adam Pearce hasn't exactly been thrilled with you this year and even at points during your tenure on Raw. Going broader, do you think that Adam and Sonya are leading fairly at this point right now?
Well, it seems they and Adam in particular have some kind of agenda against Drew McIntyre. I'm sure it'll all be revealed in time. Maybe I did something Raw to offend him. Maybe he didn't like being called Jack Tunney when I was still trying to remember his name. I don't know. Maybe I hurt his feelings at some point or another. But if he keeps pushing my buttons, like I mentioned, Angela's going to connect with somebody eventually. Maybe it'll be Pierce.
Well, to the point of Angela and Adam Pearce, he was lamenting the loss of his desk on Twitter a couple days ago. We all saw this. It's a moment in time. With it being the holiday season, though, Drew, any thoughts on getting Pearce a new desk?
Oh, absolutely not. I think he should keep that desk as a reminder of what happened with Drew McIntyre. So the next time he thinks about screwing with me, he'll see that hole in the desk and think twice.
Should get him, the Michael Cole mine. Just hide him in there for the whole show. I think that'll work out a lot better.
I don't want to bring back the Cole mine.
All right, worth a shot.
Drew, bring back the anonymous GM as well when we're at it.
Well, I've been watching that lately. No computers, please. Thank you very much. It's been a couple of months since your return to the Blue Brand. And other than obviously what happened at Survivor Series with you and Bobby Lashley, you haven't lost the match on SmackDown. To what do you attribute this great start?
Highly motivated, that's for sure. On Raw, I had the greatest success of my career, became champion, face of the brand, face of WWE throughout the most difficult times in the company's history. But towards the end of 2021, I lost a few big matches. And with the move to SmackDown, there's a chance to get a fresh coat of paint. Start on SmackDown where it began for me so many years ago. That's how I've been looking at it, as everything's come full circle. I started my career in SmackDown. Things were going so well until they weren't. And I've had a chance now to redo things. I always compare it to Quantum Leap. For anyone that's a little bit older out there, remembers Quantum Leap. It's a chance to put right what once went wrong. This part of my career, I intend to have a successful run on SmackDown. It's so far so good. And when I get that big match, I intend to make a big statement by taking down, I can't say the big dog, I guess. He's the head of the table these days, but whatever.
There are things back around to that match. Considering Happy Corbin is the one who kind of made this challenge on behalf of Madcap Moss, are you going to attempt to neutralize him, heading into day one?
I dare Corbin to get involved. I can't even count the amount of times I've kicked Corbin in the face. Like, maybe he just enjoys it so much that he always gets involved in my business. So I don't care if Corbin's out there. I don't care what shenanigans he pulls. He knows in the end, Drew McIntyre is always going to take his big 14 and put it right between his eyes.
And heading into 2022, though, do you have some goals that you're setting out for yourself? Once we walk away from day one pay-per-view, what you're looking to accomplish in 2022?
Just keep on the path that I'm on right now. Every match I'm given is an opportunity. I know there's a lot of hungry superstars on SmackDown, and I'm the hungriest of all. I'm looking for that match with Cesaro. We've never had a singles match in our entire career, 20 year apiece. Looking forward to that one when it finally happens. We've got the Royal Rumble coming up. I assume some higher powers don't want me to get that title match. There's nothing they can do about it if I win the Royal Rumble once again. So my thoughts right now, my mind is on day one. Then we've got the Rumble. We're into WrestleMania season. I'm looking for that big match at WrestleMania. I'm looking for my big moment at WrestleMania in front of a live audience.
Drew, just strictly as a fan, because you're a big fan, do you have a rooting interest in Brock Lesnar against Roman Reigns for the Universal Championship at day one?
I'll be watching like everybody else. I honestly don't care who wins. I've been in the ring with both of those men. I know what they're capable of. The match with Brock when I won my first WWE Championship was one of the biggest moments of my career. Winning against Brock Lesnar just put me at a different level, cemented me as a superstar that could be on top of the mountain. With Roman Reigns, I've not had more big matches or a bigger feud since I returned to WWE than Roman. And it's interesting now
that we've both hit our peak with the roles reversed. Yep. And last year at Survivor Series, Roman had an opportunity to see what I'm all about these days. And it took his family to get involved and shenanigans to ensure he came out with that title. So I know he's avoiding me as much as he possibly can. I'll be watching the match just like everyone else, excited to see who comes out on top. Then I'll be gunning for them.
Right on. Drew, you mentioned having your moment in front of the WWE Universe. We always poll the audience for questions. We had a ton for you. The WWE Universe loves you, as you know. This is from Samantha S. on Twitter. If you could go back in time to witness one match in person, what would it be? I thought this was a really interesting one.
Oh, man, that's too many. At least I was there for Shawn and Taker at the Manias, which was amazing to watch live. I'll go with Bret Hart and Stone Cold Steve Austin from WrestleMania 13.
That's a great answer.
That's a match that I still watch to this day often, and it stands the test of time, which not all matches do. Such unbelievable competitors, storytelling, and a double turn at the end. It was just a perfect, perfect match.
Yep.
What's also cool about that, Drew, if you were there, they have like a 5-minute brawl through the crowd. So it's like you could have actually been involved in the match. So that would have been pretty rad.
Heck yeah. That would
have been. And then we can flip to Lizzie on Twitter. Kurt Warner has a movie coming out about his life. Lizzie's going to flip this to you. Drew, if they made a movie of your life, who would play you?
Ooh. I mean, I could probably play myself, I guess.
Yeah, I knew
you're seeing the Howard Stern's movie?
Yep.
He still plays himself when he's in college and whatever, and they do the wigs and the likes. So, yeah, I could play myself. I shave this thing off. I look about 12 years old still. Maybe I'd have to lean up a little bit. I do look like Drew 8, the previous version of Drew from my early 20s in WWE. So I might need some time between each scene to lean up a bit, then bulk up again. But, yes, I will play myself.
Good one.
All right. Well, Drew, we are already looking forward to number 13th time that you join us on the bump. But before we let you go, any last words for your opponent heading into day one?
Ooh, some last words for Madcap. Was appropriate. Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Who's there?
Oh.
Drew McIntyre, and he's going to beat your arse at day one, Madcap. It's the best I've come up with on the spot. It's equally as terrible as Madcap's jokes.
No, was way better.
Congratulations. You made it to the dance. You made it on the big show. You've had your TV time. You're getting your big match. But, mate, you ain't going to win this one.
All right. Well, Drew, thank you so much, and happy holidays, and we wish you the best of luck. We'll see you at day one.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you as always, Drew.
Yeah. Thank you all once again. I'll see you at Lucky 13.
That's
yes. Right. Oh, that's going to be a good one.
All right. He's right. He's always locked in. Jokes? No. Strong messages to Madcap Moss.
We got
to
work on that song.
Deep trouble at day
12 days of Drew.
Before we say goodbye on this episode, you know, it is, again, a couple days away from Christmas time, do we have any words that you would like to share with our WWE Universe? Thanking you guys for such an incredible year, for example. I mean, the next time we see you, we'll be...
You're telling me what to say?
Oh,
guys, I'm so happy that you watched the show, because Kayla told me to say that. We are very excited, because the nice thing is we get to come back and do this next week. We're going to talk to X-Pac. We're going to talk to Bobby Lashley ahead of his WWE Championship match at day one. And last year was a huge year for him. It's nice to kind of... We always bring that up with Drew. Where is everybody going? What are they thinking about in 2022? What are they thinking about in the new year? A lot of goals get set. And Ryan, as we know, Royal Rumble coming up, WrestleMania two nights, very stupendous. You start to think ahead to those times.
Right now is when you literally, I think every single superstar across the board, across the brand, start to conceptualize what their January through April
Taker
are going to look
like. Taker told us that a few weeks ago
literally,
right here.
Yeah, literally, super rad that happened. Kayla, to your point, everything's so crazy in the world right now. We just appreciate y'all on the ride with us every single week, and we wish y'all the happiest of holidays across the board. And then, yeah, a happy Royal Rumble WrestleMania season soon to follow. So thank y'all.
I was asking you about if you wanted to say anything nice to our fans instead of talking about, you know.
Instead of talking about our big day one show coming up on January 1st in Atlanta. Very excited.
We just love all of you.
We do thank everybody
for
joining us. The interaction we get from the show during, before, after, people picking it up weeks ahead of time or after. It's like, wait, that happened on the show. Sami Zayn, we even like him, although I hope those figures will return? Because I noticed he took them and left with them.
Maybe he's giving them away.
That was a whole scene.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But we thank everybody,
of course. We do appreciate you. This is like the joy every single week for all of us. I mean, not especially me. I'm not. But I love you guys. And this is, this is such a gift. And we're super excited to see what we're able to bring to you guys in the new year, which is, it's wild.
Maybe you'll be friends with Paul Heyman in the new year.
Anything's possible at this point.
Who knows?
He'll give you the turtle dove.
Well, anyway, guys, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you join us next week. Be safe, be healthy, be happy. Happy holidays. Follow us along on social media. You know all of those things. And yes, we appreciate you guys. Matt, happy holidays, you guys.
Oh, thanks, Kayla.
And to our crew who built this studio.
The best.
Best.
The absolute best. See you next week. Forever.
Merry Christmas. Happy holidays. Shout out to Insane.
My gingerbread shirt. Keep on, yeah. Don't let them stop you from winning.